In a world with VHS SDK installed, we can come down to VHS examples Udon program sources, and we can see a bunch of example Udon scripts provided by the VHS devs for us to learn from. Today, we'll be looking at the script button sync become owner. Now, this script is a modified version of the base script button sync owner, and thus this video is a continuation of my video covering it. I recommend watching that video first, as well as my other short video covering button sync anyone. So, how is the script different? Well, like button sync anyone, when we playtest the script, we can see that both players can click the button to increase the number. That being said, before when player 2 clicked the button, player 1 would see the value increase first. Whereas here, we see that whenever player 2 clicks the button, they see the updated number first. So, what's the difference? Let's come back into Unity and open up the script. Now that we're in the script, this looks a little different, but let's break it down. Before, when the event on click played, it would check to see whether or not we are the local player, and only if we are, would it add 1 to our int. In the script, however, instead of going into a branch node, we go into a block node. This node is mainly used for cleanliness, but the way it works is that it plays the first arrow in all its parts before playing the second part. Now, if we look at the second part of our script, this is the same code that we used to add 1 to our int. So, the point of interest is what's going on before that. Now, this block node's first arrow goes into this networking set owner node that will set the owner of the object. This node here is saying to make us, the local player, the owner of this game object. So, we essentially taking ownership of the object so we can edit its synced variables. When it comes to ownership transfer, it'll assume that we are the owner of the object from the point that the node is called. Therefore, any variable changes from the previous owner, from the time that we played this node, will be lost, so do take care. If the ownership transfer fails for whatever reason, any variable changes we made will be discarded and replaced by the owner's values. Transferring ownership can simplify your coding and makes your functions seem more snappy as they become local changes instead of networked events having to travel from your computer to the owner. And transferring ownership works fine in most cases, in fact it's preferable in a lot. But if you can't afford to lose clicks, then this isn't a reliable way of syncing your variables. Then again, that doesn't usually matter. Fun fact, whenever you use a pickup script, it will make you the owner of the object. So, hope you found this helpful. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!